looking at you? He has not taken his eyes off you since you got here, Gabriela. That one. Huh? You see what I mean? It's only been hours since you came, and look how you've managed to make that guy suffer. He's smitten by you.
Enough. How can you say that, Adriana?
Oh, yes, it's easy to tell. I know what I'm saying. You can see that the way he's acting makes it so obvious.
No, just stop. Maybe he's staring because he thinks I look familiar or something.
Yeah, right. Maybe.
You know what? I think I've seen him somewhere now that I've taken a good look.
And you have to remember the most important thing. You should keep in mind all times that your job is to arrange the bottles which come out of here and keep them in order so that not a single one falls out and breaks. And aside from that, you also have to make sure that the motor keeps on running because its function is very important to this whole operation.
Hey, miss, are you all right? Can you hear me? Are you okay?
Well, you don't think that it's that complicated, right? Pablo?
Please stay with me. Please don't die on me, miss. Hang in there. Don't die. Please.
Pablo.
What?
I asked you if you think this is too complicated for you, if you understood.
Oh, no, not at all. I don't think it is.
I don't know. I just feel like you haven't been paying any attention.
No, how can you say that? I can't be disrespectful to someone who's a great teacher.
Well, thanks.
Just a second.
All right, Pablo. Aside from
back.
What I mentioned, another thing that you should also remember is that...
I gotta go. So this is where everything should go?
Yes. That's what they told me.
Everything seems very complicated when you're new, right? Nice to meet you. Pablo Rodriguez.
Gabriela Rueda. Is something wrong?
Haven't we met before?
No, I don't think we have.
What's wrong?
I guessed you would use that line on me, and I guess I was right.
Am I really as predictable as other guys out there?
It looks that way.
Wait a minute. I think I actually know you from somewhere.
Well, if you say so.
Are you some sort of athlete? An inline skater? If I've mistaken you for someone else, I'm sorry.
The most important thing you should do is to check the expiration date. What you should do is...
Adriana!
Give me a minute. Yes, madam?
Where's the new girl?
I sent her to the warehouse to bring a couple of cases. Yeah.
But it's been quite a while since I last saw her.
Oh, since she's new, maybe she lost her way finding the restroom. Maybe that's it.
It's really strange, you know? I haven't seen the new guy either.
Huh? What do you mean?
Well, Madame Cremenza, when the guy headed to the warehouse to bring some cases, I also saw the new girl leave. One minute she was working with Adriana, the next she was at a warehouse. Could it be that those two got lost together? Here, ma'am.
Tattletale.
That was 6 months ago in Cartagena. The race was going to be one of the most important moments of my life. There were skaters from the country and all over the world. Too bad for me, though. All of those are just memories now.
Why? What happened?
Because before I was able to compete in the finals, I had an accident. A drunk driver ran me over. I tried my best to recover from what happened. I wanted to get back in the game, but the doctor said that a career in inline skating was no longer an option for me. Your turn now.
What about me?
How did you know about my skating?
I remember your face.
You mean you were also in Cartagena?
No, I just saw you on the news. That event was all over television. And I remember seeing you in one of your victories.
Yeah.
You know what this means? Now I'll be able to say that I actually have a popular friend who went on TV.
What a nice sight this is. I didn't know that you were getting paid to get to know each other.
We're not, madam.
No, of course not. You're here to work, not to chat. But if you want to continue talking, I can bring you two some coffee to make this nice little conversation even lovelier.
Madame Carmenza, that's not true.
No, hold on right there. I'll handle this, Gabriela. Why are you treating us like this? Who exactly do you think you are?
I can and will treat you in any way that I want. Would you like me to remind you who I am?
Stop for a moment, because I'm not done yet. The reason why we're both in here is not because we want to. We were asked to come.
Enough of that. I don't want to hear that again because nobody asked you to come here. First, I am the one who gives all the orders in this place. And second, your job doesn't have anything to do with this warehouse and you have no reason to be in here. Listen carefully because I want this to be crystal clear. This is not a rehabilitation center for juveniles like you. If you feel that you can't follow rules and behave appropriately as adults and workers should in this company, then in my opinion, you shouldn't be here anymore. It's better if you leave. Look for a job somewhere else. You got that? Am I understood?
Of course, madame.
Young man, how about you?
Understood, madame.
Then that's it. Back to work. Get back there.
Excuse me, ma'am.
I think that woman's the worst, Gerardo. I can say nobody I've met in my life can come close to her.
Yes, you're right. I agree. Everyone knows that Madame Carmencita has a bad temper.
Oh, I don't mean Madame Carmencita. The witch I was referring to is that Veronica.
Oh, stop that. Try not to be so harsh on Veronica.
Liar. What a snitch. Tattletale. And not to mention a big fake.
That's enough. If you look at the situation, the new girl is to blame. It's true. I'm sorry. Don't you see? It's taking her long to get back. It's been a while since she left.
Oh, I can't believe you said that. It's useless to get into this argument. You know what? There is something I think your friend should be doing.
In case you don't know, we're not friends. We're very far from that.
She should be working, Gerardo. She should be working because she's paid to do that. We're all here for that reason and not to mess with other people's lives. That's all she seems to be doing. I hate that witch.
Gabriela, I wanted to tell you I honestly had no reason to go in there. That's the truth.
Listen, if all you wanted was to ask if we've met before, you simply should have waited for lunch break instead of making up excuses like what you did.
All right. Let's get back to work.
So she scolded you?
Well, she had a reason.
What happened?
Oh, nothing.
Pablo, I tried my best to help you. You see, Madame Carmenza approached me and asked why you weren't with me, but since you left, without saying where you were going, I didn't know what excuse to tell her. Listen, let's make an agreement. The next time you want to get out of here, tell me where you're going, and I will cover for you, hmm? It's that simple. You can count on me. See you later.
Yes, sir. I've sent someone to check all of the machines. And by next week, they will be in perfect condition.
Ah, great, great. That's very good to hear. By the way, Carmenza, I'd like to ask you about something else. How is that young man I recommended?
Well, if you want me to be honest, he's not doing well, sir.
What did he do?
Sir, don't worry about it, please. The situation is nothing I can't handle by myself.
Just trust me, Carmenza. Whatever it is, you can tell me. I don't personally know that young man. I made the recommendation because I promised his family I'd help him, but I don't have any obligation to him.
Well then, if that's the situation, sir. He came late on his first day to work, and he brought nothing with him. He had no resume, no letters of recommendation, and he lied to me too. I caught him loitering outside his workstation, and to top it all off, he was flirting with one of the employees. Can you believe the nerve of that man, sir? Sir, are you there?
Yes. Carmenza, I'm sorry. Another call was coming in through the other phone line. Well, anyway, like I told you before, don't worry about this. If you have to make a decision, go ahead. You can fire him. We are not keeping in the company anyone who's useless.
Well, thank you so much for trusting my judgment, sir.
I have two children. Oh, they're really wonderful kids, you'll see. My mother takes care of both of them, while I try to make ends meet by working here at the factory. Gabriela, it's pretty tough raising them on my own.
I bet it must be really difficult.
Yes. Oh, it's lunchtime now. Did you bring your lunch?
No.
You know, you should bring your lunch. Don't worry, I have a solution. Not far from here is a small restaurant where I have my food warmed up every day. Mm-hmm. I know that their prices are really affordable, so if you want, you can come with me and buy some food,
oh,
okay?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Let's go then.
Yes, Gabriela, let's go.
How's everything going?
I'm fine.
I want us to talk. I have something to say.
And you are on your own? I don't want to hear him profess his love to
no,
you.
No, Adriana, please don't go.
Oh, you can handle this by yourself later, all right? You can invite your friend to come. Bye.
I would like to apologize.
Oh, What was that? Why did you have to do that to me?
I didn't know that wasn't very nice of you.
How cute of you. You're all here waiting for me.
Isn't the hot new girl coming with us?
Gabriela is a girl's name.
So shall we wait for her or not? I can't wait any longer.
No, she can go by herself. Let's go.
Let's go.
Wait just a minute. I have to make a phone call first. One of my kids is sick. It's an important phone call. I have to find out how my child is.
Just call from the restaurant. So how is the new girl doing so far?
She's doing pretty well. I can see that she works really hard and she's nice to talk to as well. I have no problems dealing with her.
No. That's not true. That's not true what she just said, because that girl was scolded on her first day.
Well, yes, but whose fault was it? It's a new guy's fault. He's pretty intense, don't you
think
so?
How can you say that? And why are you two looking at me?
She's there with him, hoping for a quick way out.
Surely that guy doesn't know how big a mess he's getting himself into. Mr. Congeniality gave that girl a job in this company for a reason. And maybe he wants her to pay him back for the favor.
No, that's possible. You must admit
it's a really good idea.
Well, I agree on this one.
His mind's working, thank God.
You really love to gossip, don't you? Come on, let's go. Come on, stop gossiping.
Stop being silly, Pablo. After all, she had the right to reprimand us for what we've done.
So you think what you did was right?
She already made the rules very clear to me, and after all, this is my first day. I was late to begin with, and now this problem with you.
Well, I guess you're one of those people who are willing to put up with a dictatorship.
It's nothing like a dictatorship. But this is a job, and we have responsibilities. We have rules and regulations to follow, and I plan to do them.
Yeah. Are you having lunch out with the other workers?
Yeah, well, aren't you?
I'm not sure.
Well, if you make up your mind, I'm going to have lunch with them at this little restaurant. It's not far from
here. Why don't you and I go somewhere else for lunch? It's on me. I feel like somehow I owe you. I got you into this mess.
What's up? Where are you going in that outfit?
Why do you even care to ask?
Oh, please relax. I was just curious. That's it. I'm actually here because I need to ask you something. Have you seen Gabriela around here?
Who? You mean the new girl?
Yeah. Why?
Oh, Ernesto, honestly, do you plan to make her pay you for that little favor?
Listen, I asked you a question, so answer me. Have you seen her or not?
If you came to get your girl, well, I think you're a little too late.
What do you mean? I don't get it.
Because the apple of your eye is turning out to be a bit smarter than you think she is. She must be somewhere flirting around with Pablo.
Pablo? Who's Pablo? Hey, come back here.
I want to go somewhere with good food, but it has to be nearby. Don't worry, we'll be back before lunchtime is over, I promise you. After you.
Let's go.
Thank you.
That's what I mean. Do you see what's happening? It's only halfway through her first day, and she's dating someone. Oh, I feel so sorry for you.
I guess that leaves us. We can have lunch.
I'm sorry, Ernesto. I'm so sorry to reject you, but I'm not second best. I'm too good for your taste in women.
Okay, Mother, just keep on giving him medication, and I will try to get home as soon as possible, all right? I'll see you later. Goodbye. Mr. Carmelo, thanks a lot for the phone.
Hello?
You know, I've been driving around here for 20 minutes.
Let me remind the difference between your job and mine is that I have a number of hours to complete before I can leave. Boss, shall we get out of here?
You know what else I noticed?
What?
The car the man was driving looked expensive.
No.
It must have appeared expensive with how it looked. It could just be cheap.
No, Gerardo, I know what I saw earlier. I saw Veronica hop on that expensive car.
No. Well, here's an idea. That could be a relative's car. Don't you think so?
Yes,
no.
Right.
So you really think that woman has a relative who owns a nice car like that? Use your brain.
Oh, no, no. Stop that. Stop that, Adriana. Sorry to say this, but even if you don't like Veronica, for one reason or another, you can't make up stories about her, especially ridiculous ones like what you told us.
Why don't you watch your mouth? Show some respect, Gerardo. I know exactly what I saw. I'm very sure.
Well, if you're so sure about that, let me ask you something. Do you think that if Veronica were dating a person with lots of money, why is she here? A mere worker at this company like the rest of us.
Oh, right. You have a point there.
Or better yet, let me change the question. Do you really think that a filthy rich guy like that one with the expensive, luxurious car would be interested in a woman like Veronica? The answer in your head right now must be
actually,
no.
Actually, yes. Come to think of it, Gerardo has made a good point.
Waiter, can I have my check, please?
But I saw it. You gotta believe me.
Anyway.
Hey, by the way.
Yeah?
Can you please do me a little favor? Can you just lend me some money so I can pay for my lunch?
I have to go as well.
No, you can leave me here. Where are you going? Gerardo, not again.
Well, you see,
You owe me five now.
Is there anything wrong?
Where are we? This place looks really expensive.
Gabriela, please don't worry about it. Are you okay?
Yes, but the people in this fancy place look very elegant, and look how we look.
But we aren't asking them anything for free, Gabriela. I'm going to pay like everyone else. We're customers, just like all of these people. Shall we sit over here?
Yes.
What happened with Pablo? Is he home from the factory already?
Yes, yes, he's already home.
Oh, all right, that's good to hear.
But the bad news is that it took him merely half an hour to cause another problem. He was found flirting while on duty with another worker in the warehouse at the factory.
Oh, please, not again.
I don't know why, but your son must be convinced that we're not serious about this matter. He's never going to change.
What are you going to do this time?
I'm going to try to make him understand that it's not enough for him just to get a job. He should be able to stay employed. But as long as he acts this way, living like a king, just as he always has, it will be difficult for him to comprehend these ideas.
Well, have you given a thought about canceling all of his credit cards and his checking accounts as well?
Of course, Mercedes. That's what we should do. We should cut him off.
Yes, I know. I already took care of that this morning.
I wish there was some way to get out of this place. Pablo, you see the prices on this menu? This place is charging us for the entire cow, not just for one piece of steak.
Please, Gabriela, order anything you want. It's okay.
What, are you the owner of this restaurant or something?
I already told you, there's no need to worry. Excuse me, miss. Can I see the wine selection, please?
Yes, sir, just a second. Wine selection? Pablo, just in case you forgot, we have to get back to work.
Who said anything about getting terribly drunk, Gabriela? We're just going to have one glass of wine each. It'll make our meal taste better, that's all.
Here's your food.
Thank you very much, Mrs. Olga.
Ernesto, why don't you just go over to the house? There's lunch waiting for you there.
Don't worry, Mrs. Olga. This is absolutely fine. I don't want to disturb your husband.
Oh, no. You shouldn't worry about those two.
You shouldn't worry. Really, I'm fine.
Well, tell me what happened with Gabriela.
This is certainly one hot tamale.
Ernesto?
It's nothing, Mrs. Olga. Don't worry about it.
So just tell me what happened.
Well, I went to pick her up at the factory so we could have lunch together, but she already went out.
But did she know that you were going to have lunch together?
Actually, she didn't know. I wanted it to be a surprise. I was the one who got surprised.
Well, then, don't you let that get in the way. Stop feeling so down, Ernesto. Listen, she must have a good explanation. I'm pretty sure she must have gone out with her co-workers to socialize and make some friends.
Yes, that must be it. She was with this guy, a new worker. And it appeared to me that she likes this person. Mrs. Olga, can you do me a favor? Can you just give me something else to drink? Juice gives me acid.
No problem with that, son. I'll get it for you.
I really appreciate it.
Where am I from? I'd like for you to guess.
From here.
No, no, no. A good try, but you're wrong. I come from somewhere that's far from here, and I don't have a single relative in this place.
Do you live on your own?
I live in a simple hotel room alone, yes.
Just as simple as this place, probably.
No, not at all. The hotel I'm talking about is just one star. But Gabriela, all the cockroaches are fancy.
I don't believe a thing you're saying.
But why not?
Because I can tell that you're so used to living the good life, it's pretty obvious.
Is that because I brought you here?
What else do you expect me to think?
Gabriela, I think you just got me. Now I have to reveal my secret to you. You're the reason why I did all of this. Because I didn't think it was nice to bring you to the cheap restaurant here at the factory to eat rice, chickpeas, fried egg, or anything on their menu. I had to bring you here.
You're nuts.
But I surprised you, didn't I?
All right, I have to admit that you did.
Well, that's good to hear. It's all worth every single payment of the 36 installments I have to give so I can pay for this meal. Let's have a drink. To you.
To you.
Do you want to grab some lunch? I have about 30 minutes left.
Again, because I have an appointment. But if you're hungry, you can go ahead and call room service. Eat something while I change. Tomorrow I'll come a bit later than usual. I have a meeting that might just last the whole morning.
Well, that's good, because I have also a lot of things to finish.
Really now? Like what things?
You just stay out of my business and I'll stay out of yours as well. That's the deal, remember?
What's the matter, Veronica? Why are you upset?
No? No, Julio, I am not upset. I'm tired, that's what I am. I am already fed up that you only want to get together for one reason.
Just answer me, tell me. What other reason would we have to get together, Veronica? Remember, from the very start, it was already clear what we had between the two of us.
Well, not really, Julio. I thought that since now you have a better position in the company, things could somehow change and our relationship would be something more.
You want love?
You are just so pathetic, you know.
Well, tell me what you're expecting from me, Veronica.
You know something, Julio? Don't even bother trying.
Veronica. Veronica, come back. Please don't go. Yes.
Yes. The plan was to eventually compete in the World Championships.
How far from the competition were you?
Not far. Once you make it to the preliminary competition, you're one step closer. You cannot imagine how it was like for me, watching as my career and my entire life crumbled down. And everything fell apart because of that bastard who ran me over. That guy just brought me to the hospital and left me there. You know why he did that? Because if he didn't leave, he'd go to jail. That person was driving under the influence of alcohol. Of course, he'd very much prefer to run away rather than face the consequences. He simply left me there. In that hospital, where I had to stay and undergo several operations. I had to fight for my life and I didn't want to be bedridden. My family tried hard to find that man, especially my grandfather. He did everything he could, but he wasn't successful. He spoke to the doctors, to the policemen, to the lawyers. But nobody knew anything about the guy. The only thing we got about the person who almost killed me is that he comes from a wealthy family. And of course, he was able to get out of the situation like nothing ever happened. He probably gave those people money so they wouldn't say anything. Life's not fair, you know. If I were the one who was drunk and caused that accident, I would have gone to jail right away. There would be no way for me to escape the police. But because this person has all the money to buy his way out, he luckily has to face nothing. He had everything solved. And me? I'm left angry and very emotionally wounded, not able to do anything but tell you my story. While he's enjoying his life, his power, and all his money, he must be bragging to all his friends how we managed to get away from Cartagena.
So how long did you have to stay in the hospital, Gabriela?
About 2 months. I had to stay for 2 months in there. I had 3 surgeries, and when I got to Bogota, I went through different kinds of treatment and therapy, and to top it all off, my mother had to carry the burden of paying for everything. She had no choice but to put the house up for mortgage. You cannot imagine how much money we had to spend just so I could recover. I'm so sorry about this. This isn't a great way to end a nice lunch. You invite me to eat out and have a nice time with you, and I end up telling you about my tragedy. Now I think you'll have second thoughts about asking me out for coffee, will you? Sir.
What's the problem? What do you mean? Are you telling me there's a problem with my credit card?
That's right, sir. The bank has rejected it.
That's not possible.
Would you like me to try once more?
Fine, but try this other card.
How many payments, sir?
Just one payment.
I'm at a restaurant having lunch with a coworker, Mother.
Why didn't you have lunch with Ernesto?
Well, I didn't want to. I don't want to have anything to do with that person.
You should change your mind.
What are you saying?
What I'm trying to say here is you should exert some effort and treat that young man better. You should invite him to eat out or whatever, if only for the favor he did for you.
Mother, I already said thank you, and that should be more than enough, right? And aside from that, I don't want to give him the wrong impression.
Gabriela, can you tell me who you're having lunch with now?
I already told you, Mother. He's a friend from the factory.
Oh, yes. I've had enough lies, so please stop. Today is just your first day at work, and you already have a friend?
Listen, Mother. Honestly, it's not a good time for an argument, okay?
Oh, are you really that busy with your new friend?
No, I didn't mean to say that. It's just that I have to get back to my job now, and I really don't want this to make me late. We'll talk later when I'm home. Bye.
Hold on, young lady. You have to explain yourself first. Hello? Gabriela? Gabriela!
This one has been rejected too, sir. I'm sorry.
Oh, well, all right. Can you please do a big favor for me?
Of course. What is it, Mr. Cordoba?
That's exactly it. Don't call me Mr. Cordoba, okay? Feel free to call me Pablo. It's just that Mr. Cordoba makes me feel very old.
I would recommend that you get in touch with your bank about this situation, Mr. Pablo.
Anything wrong?
Can you try this credit card once more?
Pablo, what's the matter? We're gonna be late.
No, just a second. Wait. Mother, my credit cards have all been rejected. The bank didn't tell me the reason. The only thing they told me is that all my accounts have been canceled.
Where are you now?
At the Café de las Letras.
Where did you say?
It's a restaurant that's not far from the factory, Mother.
And what are you doing in that restaurant? Aren't you supposed to be at the factory doing your job?
Well, for your information, the workers are also given time to have their lunch.
Yes, and because you need your credit card, I can imagine what kind of lunch you're having at your first day of work. Who are you having lunch with?
A co-worker at the factory.
My goodness! This is only your first day at your new job and you're already flirting with a woman? You think what you're doing is appropriate?
I need you to give me money.
Why? Why are you asking me for money? No, it's not me who's being irresponsible. I didn't get out of work to go on a date with someone.
Listen, I'm so sorry, Pablo, but
this time, you will have to start solving all your problems on your own.
Good job. I really think you did only what's best for him.
After that, I can only be sure of one thing. At this very moment, I have absolutely no doubt my son hates me.
This is the bank's fault. They're never able to help you when you need them. I should just stop trying these credit cards. They're clearly useless.
What do we do then?
As much as I want to pay in cash, I can't because I don't have a single penny.
I'll ask you again, Pablo. What should we do with this?
I really don't know, Gabrielle. I offered to leave my mobile phone, but they told me this isn't a pawn shop. Maybe if you have some cash on you...
Pablo, do you think that my salary at the factory is enough to pay a bill in this kind of restaurant? I said it earlier, Pablo. You didn't listen. This place is too expensive for us. We shouldn't have come.
Well, I've come up with a solution, Gabriela.
What?
Why don't we both just get out of here? Admit it, the idea sounds good. At least we won't be late for work.
Hello? Oh, it's you. Hi, cousin.
Hello, Urani. Where are you now?
I'm on my way to the house right now. What's up?
I really need to ask you a huge favor.
All right then, Gabriela. Go ahead and tell me what it is.
Will you let me borrow some money?
I'm not sure I can, cousin. It all depends on how big an amount you need. How much? My goodness, Gabriela, why do you need to borrow that much money from me?
I need that money to pay a restaurant bill.
My God, that is one insanely huge restaurant bill you have there. Come on, cousin, that's enough to feed everyone at home for a month, you realize
that? But it's all done, Urani. Do me a favor. Can you find your way to the Café de las Letras?
Yes, I know that restaurant. Isn't it on the way to the factory where you work?
That's perfect. Just take a taxi. Make it quick. I need to have that money.
All right, but then, Gabriela, even if I get there, we'll still have a major problem. Where am I going to get the money? Hello? Hello, Gabriela!
What did your cousin tell you?
She's on her way here.
That's good news. I'll be the one to wait for her. Go back to the factory, Gabriela. I don't want you to get in trouble because of me.
Pablo, do you really think I could leave you here on your own?
You don't have any? No, I already called him and he told me he doesn't have any money as well. All right then. No, please don't bother. Thank you, see you around.
Is everybody back from lunch break?
Yes, everyone's here, madam. The rest are at the cafeteria having coffee.
Well, do me a favor. Call them and tell them I will be waiting at the factory so I can talk to everyone.
All right, Madam Carmenza?
What is
it? Those two new workers. I haven't seen them around. That new girl seems like a troublemaker, don't you think so? She just got here and already she's looking for a husband. She's quite a nuisance. Please excuse me, Madame Carmenza.
Gabriela, is that her?
Gabriela!
But yes, I thought she'd never come. Go and ask them to call a taxi for us, okay?
Okay.
Hello. Oh. So do you have the money with you?
I do. I didn't know this place was so nice and it's very elegant, too.
Yes, but it's ridiculously expensive.
I can only imagine.
Thank you. Who lent this to you?
Nobody.
What?
Gabriela, listen, I knew that Aunt has been keeping this money in a drawer to pay the water bill, so I went ahead and took it. It's okay if I borrow it first.
No, how can that be okay, Yurani?
What did you want? Did you want me to leave you here and just do nothing to help? I can't do that, cousin. Is that him? Is that the guy who invited you to have lunch here? I have to admit, I find him quite hot.
Stop, don't stare at him.
I told you I finished checking all of the drawers. I've opened and checked every single one of them several times, but I can't find the
How
money.
How is that possible? I know for sure that the money's in there.
I already told you I didn't see the money. Didn't you use it to pay for something else? Maybe you just forgot you did.
And why would I do such a thing? I set aside the money for that purpose. Today is the deadline
and you need to go to the bank to pay the bill.
Wait a minute. I didn't want to be pointing fingers at anybody, but what about your husband? He could have taken the money. Isn't that possible?
No, Guillermo won't do that.
You should have reserved your judgment.
Oh, he wouldn't do that, Father.
He knows that he can't take money without my permission, and he wouldn't dare go behind my back. He knows better than to break that rule.
Where's the money, then?
Just keep on looking.
And that's exactly what I'm doing right now.
Gabriela, wait. As soon as they let us out from the factory, I'll go to the bank. I promise I'll do everything to fix this problem, and then I'll bring you your money as soon as I can,
Father,
okay?
You better pray to God that we haven't lost our jobs yet. As soon as Madame Carmenza finds out we're late, she'll fire us. Let's hope she doesn't know we just got here. Let's go.
Hello there.
Hello there.
What's up? Is there something wrong here?
I've been looking all over for your aunt's money. I really need to find it immediately because the deadline for the bill payment is today. Yeah, she's here. I was just about to ask her to help me look for the money. Darling, can you help me? Your aunt is saying it's inside a drawer.
You're so late. Where have you been?
That can wait. What did the boss say?
I don't know what she has to say. All of the workers had a meeting with Madame Carmenza, but she didn't say anything about the two of you being late.
She didn't. That can't be bad.
Yes, that can't be bad. Pablo, can you please do me a favor?
Sure.
Can you stay here while I go to the restroom?
Of course.
Really? Madame Carmenza! The two new workers arrived just now.
Hello.
Pablo, I'm asking you. Just go back to your post, okay?
What?
I'm asking you to please go back to your post and work.
But look, there's nothing else to do. Stop worrying because Madame Carmenza didn't notice that we came in late. I enjoyed that experience with you because it strengthened our bond.
I can't say I enjoyed it, but maybe it would have been different if you only remembered to consider bringing cash aside from your credit cards, because you did give the invitation.
Well, okay, you're right. That's very logical. I know that. But I got the chance to know more about you and your life as well.
Excuse me, Mr. Pablo. Aren't you supposed to be working next to Veronica?
Yes, Madame Carmenza. What happened is that
I'm really very curious to know more about something else, young man. How was lunch for both of you? It must have been delicious. If you spend most of the afternoon having lunch, I can only guess it must have been wonderful. You know what? This factory is a workplace, a company, not the venue for a budding romance as beautiful as the one between you two. So please do me a favor. Please take off your overalls, go to the locker room and change, get yourselves out of here because at this very moment you have lost your jobs.
Don't you think it's very unfair for you to just fire us like that?
You are just unbelievable, aren't you? It is better if you leave. I have had enough of your arrogance.
Why don't you believe me? We encountered an unexpected problem.
To me, that's not important. Your problem doesn't matter.
See, we were supposed to be here much earlier, but there was a problem with the restaurant bill because my credit cards were rejected and we had to wait for someone who'd pay for us.
I can't believe it. You mean those canteens where the workers eat accept credit cards now? Listen to me, sir. I have an advice for you. It's for free. Why don't you look for another job that's more appropriate for you? Maybe you could be an executive or a manager. That way you can take all the time you need to have a nice long lunch whenever you want to, don't you agree?
Madame Carmenza, I'm begging you, please give us some consideration.
Look, young lady, I've given you consideration. I even allowed you to enter the factory so you can clear out your things from the locker.
Here's a suggestion, Madame Carmenza. You can fire me.
No.
Yes, you can't fire Gabriela. She didn't do anything.
You have to be kidding. She's a damsel in distress and you're her knight in shining armor? What kind of luck do I have?
I'm just asking you to think it over and reconsider your decision.
Tell me what possible reason would I have to reconsider my decision? Who are you to ask me to try and change my opinion? That's it. I've wasted too much time, so please get out. I'm very busy today, all right? Please leave.
I can't believe what she did. She should have given us a second chance. Gabriela, I'm sorry.
Pablo, you don't have to say anything.
But this whole thing is my fault.
We cannot blame either of us. You invited me out to lunch and I accepted. There's nothing we can do about this.
So what are you going to do now?
Well, I guess I have to give my mother the good news right away. She'll be upset for sure.
Do you want me to come with you?
How'd that help?
I was thinking maybe I can explain to her what happened at work.
No, I know they'll scold me for losing my job, but if you came, it'll worsen. They'll kick you out of the house. We've had enough trouble for today. It's more than enough, actually.
All right.
Stop blaming yourself. This is certainly not the end of the world. There are lots of other jobs waiting out there. I'll be able to find one.
What if you do inline skating like before? The fact that you're here means you've been given another opportunity, and it's a chance to go after your dream of being a champion.
I wish I could do that, Pablo. But because of that accident, my chance to fulfill my dream was suddenly gone. I had lost my opportunity and it became so clear to me that skating was no longer an option for me. Shall we go?
Can you honestly say to me that you would trust a person who's late on her first day at work? Because I can't do that.
Oh, Carmencita, please listen to me. If Gabriela came in late today, it must be because she encountered a problem. It must be really something serious, because that's not the way she is.
Maybe she isn't, but today she was late and a lot more.
Oh, no. Listen, let me tell you that this lady's very disciplined. You should know this about her. She was a skater before, a professional one.
And so what does that have to do with what we're discussing right now?
Don't you understand that, Carmencita? Come on. She was an athlete. An athlete is all about hard work, rigid training, and strong commitment. She is a great worker.
Oh, Ernesto, you would do and say anything to help someone and then ask for something in return for what you did.
No, all right. Take her back, and I'm willing to put myself on the line for her. I'll take responsibility for the girl, and I promise that she will never disappoint you.
You know something? I am not totally convinced.
Carmencita, I'm begging you. Do me a favor. Like I mentioned, I assume responsibility for her, and I assure you she won't let you down ever. Oh, don't make me beg you some more. It's becoming very uncomfortable. Okay, just tell me one thing. What time do I tell her to report for work tomorrow, huh?
I did not say that I am giving her a second chance.
No, you haven't. But after all these years, I know you. You're not capable of refusing to do something for a colleague. Am I right? That's the reason I like you, Carmencita. That's exactly why I like you. And tomorrow I'll bring you some empanadas. They're very delicious. Too bad you don't like blood sausage.
Please try to calm down a little. What happened is they asked me to go to the school earlier and I had to photocopy some papers. And since I didn't have any money with me, I decided to borrow what you had inside that drawer.
You think I'm stupid enough to believe that? I want you to answer this. Since when did doing photocopies cost more than this entire household's monthly bill? Did you go out to a party? Did you? Did you use that money to pay a debt?
No, I didn't,
What did
Aunt?
You do with it? Did you buy a new dress? Did you not think first about more important needs? Jurani, what you did was just very inconsiderate. I hope you have not forgotten that your parents work very hard to be able to send you the money that you need, and you just decide to spend it on the first thing you want to get. I'm so angry because you've become so irresponsible. And what makes me even more upset is that you're using money needed to run this whole place. I'm not letting you do this again, young lady.
Oh, Auntie,
I don't want to hear any of that. Listen, Jurani. Please remember, I have covered up for you before. When you needed money, I was willing to let you borrow, and I helped you manage your finances. But if my assistance will only make you become more irresponsible and delinquent, I won't just stand and watch that happen. This is something I have to tell your parents, and I'll call them so they can make a decision. I'll advise them to come and take you back to Sagamoso as soon as they can.
No, Auntie, I'm begging you, please
don't. Why not? What do you want me to do about you then? You want me to be pleased? You have no way out this time. You know, you should have thought hard before you took that money from the drawer.
I don't understand how you'll be able to help me. It's not hard to find a job.
I'll come up with something so I can make it up to you.
Pablo, I'm not the only one who's just been fired.
But that's the least of my worries for now. Because, well, after all, I have to do something to help you get a new job and erase all of the mistakes that I did.
Oh, but you have your own life to live and you have to solve your problems.
But what happened at the factory was entirely my fault. Now I have to find a way to solve this problem.
Stop, please. Don't keep on blaming yourself. It wasn't just you, it was both our fault.
Okay, Gabriela, you can keep on insisting, but I will never give in. So later, I'll drop by your house sometime in the evening so I can give the money to you. And if everything goes really well, I might just bring you some great news. Maybe a new job? What?
You are very clueless.
I really don't think so. I'm persistent. That sounds much better. I'm very persistent.
I have to go in now.
Now?
Yes.
Oh.
I'll talk to you soon.
Sure, of course.
See you.
Bye.